Huberdeau have a night, 2-2, and the game-deciding goal. That guy elevated his game, made a huge difference.
And this is what they need from him, because he has the talent. So it's not a question of talent for Huberdeau. I think he should be a 70-75 point guy at the very minimum, I believe, just based on his skill set. But what Bob Bugner, I'm sure, is trying to impress upon him, knowing Boogie, having played with him twice in the minors and in the NHL, is just about competing every game. Because sometimes, as you were saying, sometimes the easy points aren't there. Sometimes the easy plays aren't there. Mm-hmm. You got to fight through some of that traffic and adversity. He did a great job of that tonight. Yeah. So too did their team.
He was the three C's tonight, competing, character, and competition. Yeah. So, you know, that's what to me, the number one is consistency. Mm-hmm. That's what he's got to be, because I think he's a fantastic player. And he was coached by Gerard Gallant, so you know he's got character. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he won a Mem Cup.
Absolutely.
We got a coach right here who has tremendous expertise when it comes to the PP. This was a Cats team that came in 1-for-15 on the man advantage. In this one, 2-for-7. That had to feel good for them. What was the difference?
Well, I think that, their mindset, knowing that they have to get better, I'm sure they've been working on it last day off, too, and just coming in and being focused on it. But the score of 5-on-3 is big, because if you don't score 5-on-3 and you're 1-for-15, you got a chance to go into a 1-and-35 going into the next game. But this is just great passing, one touching, and they do a great job. And then on the 5-on-3, they get a bounce. And that's what you need sometimes, too, to stimulate the team and get it going. And then they start believing in each other and they play with more confidence.
And to start the season, they were going with 5 forwards. As I was told from some members of the Panthers, they're going with 5 forwards on the power play to start. They make the adjustment. Yandel on that last power play goal, as we just saw by Dadanov. And here they're moving it. Nice rotation. Keep in mind, Torch, this is your domain. There's a lot of guys there. There's a lot of talent. Looks like they've got the 5 forwards on this one. Hard to keep everybody satisfied.
Yeah, it is. It's hard. And I mean, but it comes down to the player's character to win, because the logo comes first. Mm. That's the bottom line.
Love it.
And it doesn't matter who gets the points, and it doesn't matter who gets the goals. And I mean, you know, you watch guys like Barkov, and I mean, Hoffman's just getting in there, so he's getting adjusted on that. I mean, he's in the same spot he was in Ottawa. But I think that it's going to take them a little bit to have a better understanding of their power play. You can't judge it on the first 5 games. I usually say after 15 or 20 games, because you're still robotic and you want to feed, like we talked about San Jose's power play, and they scored 2 last night. You know, so everyone's just got to be comfortable out there and know how everyone plays. And when they're being, you know, some guys are 1-on-1 players or 2-on-1. They don't want you to come near them. And once they adjust to that, I think they're going to start scoring more goals.
You know, you gave Weeksy and I goosebumps when you talked about the logo.
Yes,
yeah, exactly. It's always about
timeless.
The logo.
That's it.
There's nothing else, and that's what people don't understand when you take a job. I mean, sometimes you got to be tough and be hard on players, but the logo comes first. And once they understand that, the team starts winning.